Hare Krishna. To resolve conflicts, begin with the 1% commonality, not the 99% difference. Whenever we are in a conflict with someone, naturally our attention and our emotion get centered on the area of conflict. We want things to be done this way, they want things to be done that way, for example. However, if we want some kind of reconciliation, if we want some kind of resolution, we need to conscientiously shift our attention from what separates us to what links us, what unites us. Because focusing or obsessing on the area of difference will only polarize us further. It polarizes, it increases the difference. So, if we want to resolve the issue, we need to focus on the similarity, on the commonality. Now we may say, no, we two of us are so different, what is common between us? Actually, if we go deeper, we will always find things that are common. Looking at the commonality is the characteristic of sattva-guna, the mode of goodness. Perception or knowledge in the mode of goodness, Krishna says in 18.20 in the Bhagavad-Gita, is characterized by seeing the essential similarity in spirituality of all living beings. Sarvabhuteshu yenaikam bhavam avyayam ikshate avibhaktam vibhakteshu tadjnanam vidyasatvikam. Sarvabhuteshu yenaikam, among all living beings, bhavam avyayam ikshate, there is one imperishable spirit that animates all of them, avibhaktam vibhakteshu, and this unites them, although at the bodily level they are all different. Seeing this, that is knowledge in the mode of goodness. So now, if we want to resolve a conflict, we need to see what are our commonalities. We are all souls, we are parts of Krishna. Even if they don't want to serve Krishna or they want to serve Krishna in a different way, still we are all parts of Krishna. We are all human beings. We are all, if we are working in a family, working in a profession, working in a spiritual community, we have so many common interests. And if we strive conscientiously to focus on the commonalities and begin with those commonalities, then we'll be able to see the good in the other person also. And once we see the good in the other person, then the negativity that is actually radiating from us towards them will decrease, and that will decrease their coldness, their hostility. And when we see the commonality and especially express our appreciation for the positive that we see in them, for the purpose that they are trying to serve, which is often good, just the process may be different. So when we appreciate it, then both ours and theirs emotional coldness goes down. And when the ice is broken, when warmth comes up, then resolutions become much easier. Often, conflicts occur not so much because of the issue, but because of what emotions people bring to the issue. And when we bring in positive emotions, then those negative emotions get overcome and issues become easier to resolve. So let's, for resolving conflicts, even if there are huge differences, even if we feel that 99% differences are there, let's begin with the 1% commonality. Thank you. Hare Krishna.